I did not write this. This would have. This is what happens if Shakespeare had written The Three Little Pigs. In times past, though not long ago, there lay three pigs in stature, little in number, three, who, being of age, both entitled and inspired, to seek their fortune, to set about to do so thusly. When they had traveled the distance, pig numbered first spake, saying, "Hearken, brethren, head this impetuous realm. Tarry me far from hearth and home, I fear we shall fare not well." And so, being collectively agreed, but individually impaled, the diminutive swine sought each to erect himself an abode. Pig number one did construct his house of straw. Pig number two did likewise, though not from straw, but instead from sticks. Meanwhile, unique in his imaginings, pig number three did erect his domicile, starward and garish structure made from brick entirely. Soon, there happened along, as frequently in scenario of classic protagonist pig or red-headed child, a wolf. Carnivorous nature in full season, he called out to the straw-staunch swine, saying, "Pray thee, little pig, grant me entrance." But pig one recalled with sage foreboding that he is mad who trusts in the tameness of a belly-pitched wolf, and responded immediately, "Nay, it shall not be indeed, not by wit or whiskled fowl." Prepared for this most expected response, the wolf replied immediately, "Thou steal thyself, little pig. Forthwith shall I endeavor employing means both huffing and puffing to dismantle your flaxen fortress." Thereupon issued forth from the wolf an exhale of gale proportions that quickly rendered straw hovel to dregs and dross, and carried aloft piglet and shattered courtiers both. Exposed now to claw and fang, piglet one made haste, wolf in pursuit, to the straw to the stick festooned sanctum of picklier secondary, causing pig two to cry with dismay, "Well, this knocks my knickers. Marshalling a feral wolf on my doorstep is nowhere among those endeavors of animal nor congenial." "A thousand pardons," squealed two, one. "'Twas would seem the beast made from breath has purged me of home and sound judgment alike." The mighty maelstrom of the wolf's exhale splattered second swine shack and shortened his sanctimonious scolding simultaneously. "Lo and behold," squealed two, "stand we now amid wounded wreckage, tremulous and vulnerable, nay, strategy for ensuing the canine devour and looming in deadly proximity." "Strategy," squealed one. "While it is noble to contemplate tactical particularities, pressed as we are with the time restraint or bidding detailed strategical conversations, I would urge we run." Whether by their own fleet-footed competence or the wolf's windless attitude, the diminutive swine arrived at their ultimate kindred neighbor's expendable brick ingress unscathed. Upon the third pig's door, with urgent hoofs, they pounded out, calling out, "Unbar this entrance, and with haste we beseech thee." The third pig hailed from the American colonies, and possessing a vocabulary substantially less robust than impromptu visitors, replied, "Say what?" "Seek we sanctuary," they implored upon the verge of hysteria, "lest we fall forthwith to the ravenous appetite of yonder approaching carnivore." Still confounded by their impromptu words, pig three did render ajar his porthole, whereupon one and two spilled through and collapsed beyond the threshold enervated. "Y'all just wanted to come in? Couldn't have said that." The sinister hiss of the wolf could once again be heard outside. "Pray thee, pigs, grant me entrance." "The wolf," cried one and two. "Wolf," said three. "What you suppose he wants?" "He seeks to gain purchase within. Indeed, he would occupy this very alcove from which we have afforded the most meager of opportunities." "Right." "I'm just going to ask him what he wants." "Under no circumstances," squealed two, flinging self bodily across the porthole. "There's none to be gained across the external opponent save our immediate demise." "What'd you say about my mama?" House occupants were again engulfed by a benevolent blast of wolfish wind. The foundation shook, the frame rattled, and lo, to the astonished eyes of piglet and crunching scoundrel alike, stood the third pig's lodging undaunted. Good news for you, pig fans. A aghast and dismayed. Pig two quarried at pig three. How does, against such relentless and torrential onslaught, does this domicile endure? Pig three, puffing out chest, tapped a hoof to the hearth and responded, "It's American made."